Hello there. Welcome to our channel. Today, we are going to be diving into the world of hypnosis apps. These intriguing tools have seen a significant uptick in the digital wellness industry. They promise a range of potential benefits from stress relief to smoking cessation. But the real question is, are they as effective and safe as they claim to be? Let's explore. Now, if you've recently stumbled across our blog post about hypnosis apps, you'd already have a pretty good understanding of what they are and how they work. The text walked us through the safety considerations and their overall effectiveness. Today, we'll dive a bit deeper into the subject, providing additional perspectives that could help you make an informed decision about using these tools. Now, first things first. The principle of hypnosis, deriving from the Greek word hypnos meaning sleep, is all about a state of deep relaxation where your subconscious mind can accept new suggestions more readily. It's a powerful tool that's been used in therapy for centuries. So, the idea of bottling that up into an app on your smartphone? Pretty exciting, right? One of the key points to remember is that while hypnosis apps have potential, their effectiveness can depend on several factors, such as the individual's susceptibility to hypnosis and personal expectations. For instance, some people are naturally more suggestible and might find these apps incredibly effective, while others might have a harder time reaching that relaxed state. This doesn't mean the apps aren't working, but rather that results can vary from person to person. Let's also consider the nature of the apps themselves. Are all hypnosis apps created equal? Well, not exactly. Just like with any product, there are high-quality, scientifically backed apps, and then there are those which, let's say, don't quite hit the mark. That's why it's incredibly important to do your due diligence before hitting that download button. Look for apps developed by professionals, read user reviews, and check if they base their content on scientifically validated techniques. Remember, while hypnosis apps can be beneficial, they are not a magic bullet. They are tools to be used in conjunction with other wellness practices and professional medical advice, especially when addressing serious conditions. The aim is to utilize them as a supplement to your overall health and well-being routine. So, what's the bottom line here? While hypnosis apps are an exciting prospect in the field of digital wellness, remember to use them wisely. But that's a little too generic, so let's dive deeper into some specific considerations around the use of these apps. Some critics argue that the results of studies supporting the effectiveness of hypnosis apps can vary due to the study's design, small sample sizes, and lack of control groups for comparison. That's why it's crucial not to take these results as gospel, but as part of a larger narrative around the potential of these apps. An interesting point to consider is that just like hypnosis in a traditional therapeutic setting, a lot of the effectiveness of a hypnosis app can come down to your personal expectations. If you're doubtful and skeptical, that might create a mental block that reduces the app's effectiveness. On the other hand, if you approach the process with a positive and open mindset, you could very well see significant benefits. A key factor in ensuring safe usage is self-awareness and responsibility. This cannot be overstated. While hypnosis apps are generally considered safe, they may trigger adverse reactions in some individuals, particularly those with mental health conditions. If you're in this category, or if you experience discomfort while using these apps, it's best to stop using the app and consult a healthcare professional. Remember, while hypnosis apps can provide self-improvement benefits, they should never replace traditional therapy or medical treatment. It's a point we cannot emphasize enough. Ultimately, the value of hypnosis apps lies in their potential to become a convenient addition to your wellness toolkit. They can be great for helping you manage stress, sleep better, or overcome certain habits. But they should be used responsibly, as part of a broader strategy for health and well-being, not as a standalone solution. That's a wrap for today. Remember, the world of digital wellness is broad and diverse, and hypnosis apps are just one part of that. Stay curious, stay informed, and always prioritize your well-being. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.